particular duck. Recognize him yet? Well, for those who don't know this particular duck, I'm sure all of you have heard of the story called The Ugly Duckling. Well, for those who haven't, The Ugly Duckling is about a duck who was too ugly for society to actually accept him, so he got cast out. Well, let me tell you one thing. The story has a happy ending because the duck turned into something really, really beautiful. So moving on, today's topic, I'll be talking about how something ugly, like the ugly duckling, turned into something more beautiful with my topic, green innovative glass ceramic. My name is Isla Nan, and I am from UTEP, and I bid you a good morning. So, before we start off anything, we actually have to identify problems. What's wrong? What's going on? Why are we actually doing this, right? The problem today is that 15,000 tons of waste is produced by Malaysians daily. Now that's daily. Imagine weekly. Imagine a month. 15,000 times 30. Can you imagine that? And that's only in Malaysia. Imagine the whole world. And 4% alone is glass waste. So that amounts to around 600 tons. Can you imagine that amount of glass in your house? I'm sure you can. So, the recyclable glass is not used constructively. Hence, the landfill is used as a quick, cheap, and dirty way to get rid of our problems, right? So, why did I actually say that the recyclable glass is not used constructively? Well, let me introduce to you the current recycling glass cycle. The current recycling glass cycle is when the glass is first collected, it's rinsed, it's crushed, and everything. And afterwards, the glass is mixed with sand, soda ash, and lime, and then heated to 1,000 degrees Celsius. Afterwards, the liquefied glass is then poured into molds and cooled slowly to increase its strength. Afterwards, it will be formed into bottles again, and the consumers will put it into bottle banks. So, what's the problem, right? There's nothing wrong here. But let me tell you one thing, there's a lot of things wrong here. Because for one thing, the disadvantages of this current cycle is that high temperature is actually needed. 1,000 degrees Celsius is not that low, you know, because let's face it, 1,000 degrees Celsius is really high. Afterwards, some of the other disadvantages is that it requires a long firing times. So, in addition to high temperature needing to actually recycle the glass and the long firing times, you actually have to use a large amount of energy to use it to just recycle it. Hence, it produces high total manufacturing costs. So, what is the quick and easy way to actually get rid of all our problems? This. Tragic, isn't it? So, how are we actually going to solve this? What's going to happen now? How are we actually going to fix this with engineering materials? Well, with the introduction to glass ceramic tiles. What are glass ceramic tiles? It is when you put all of the waste glass with a little bit of innovation and you'll get glass ceramic tiles, or how I would call it, gig tiles. So what are gig tiles actually? What's going on? Gig tiles are basically just a composition of 90% weight or more of waste glass, and you'll be using only the ingredients that are naturally from the earth as a filler to produce something as beautiful as this. Aren't they lovely? So not only can you actually use the waste glass, you can also put in ingredients such as spent bleached earth from the palm oil industry, and also incinerated ashes from the scheduled waste glass. So, let me tell you, I'm sure all of you have started asking, so I can't believe waste glass is actually better in chemical properties and stuff, right, compared to natural clay. That's where you're wrong, because the gig tiles actually has a higher water better water absorption property in comparison to standard ceramic glass. The application that we're going to be using the gig tiles on is floor and wall tiles. So for the standard alone, you have to use a minimum of 10%. Ours is only down to 0.03%. The breaking strength has to be not less than 600 newtons. ours is 2,975 newtons. And also, the modulus of rupture must be a minimum of 15 newtons per millimeter squared. Ours is up to 62.8 newtons per millimeter squared. That is way, way better than the standard ceramic tiles. And I can tell you one thing, this has been certified by Serum. Isn't that lovely? Now, I'm sure all of you have started going, you know what, I'm gonna go for cake tiles. Cake tiles is totally cool, right? Well, wait, there's more. Because the cake tiles not only helps with the current recycling style, it also helps with the current manufacturing style. Let me tell you a little bit about the current manufacturing style. The current manufacturing style actually uses raw natural material plate to 100%. So by using 100% of natural clay, that actually encourages mining, right? So not only does it encourage mining, you actually have to sinter it up to 1,000 degrees Celsius. So as a conclusion to everything, we actually have to use a high cost to actually just produce tiles and to recycle the glass. So how are we actually helping this up? Well, with the introduction to gate tiles, raw natural material is used in smaller amounts since it's only going to be used as fillers, right? Afterwards, we're going to reduce the mining because we're only going to be using our own trash again and again, because one man's trash is another man's treasure, right? Afterwards, the sintering temperature is also reduced since the new sintering temperature is only up to 850 degrees Celsius. So, afterwards, by concluding all of this, we can actually conclude that lower manufacturing temperature will equal to less energy needed and consumed, will equal to lower total manufacturing costs. Now everybody's happy. Everybody gets their money. Everybody's fine. Everybody's happy. Everybody's dandy until somebody sits there and goes, how does it work? What's going on? Well, let me tell you something. The science behind it starts on the sintering mechanism itself. What is sintering actually? Sintering is, in simple terms, if I were to explain it in really simple terms, it's basically like baking. You put in all your ingredients, put it all in, put in a mold, throw it in the oven, boom, comes out a cake, right? So that's what we're gonna do. The raw powder is formed into the form product, which is then sintered to close out all the gaps. As you can see, this is the pour. After sintering, no more pores. So, from this phase diagram, the cake tiles versus the standard ceramic tiles actually uses different sintering techniques, where our cake tiles will be using viscous glass sintering, and the normal ceramic tiles using 100% clay will be using solid state sintering. In solid state sintering, you will actually depend on the melting temperature of the clay itself, because you're using 100% of clay, right? We're going to be using a lot of energy to actually start the bonding activities between the clay itself. So, for the viscous glass sintering, you actually need to use like a lower temperature to activate the glass transition temperature, because you'll be using waste glass, right? So that consists of 90% of the cake tile. So the particles already started bonding at a lower temperature. Afterwards, as a phase, in this phase analysis diagram, you can see that for the natural clay, it will be somewhere around here. So as a comparison, the mechanism that we're going to be using for the cake tiles is using viscous glass sintering, while the mechanism used for the standard ceramic tiles is solid state sintering. The crystalline phases present is diopside, naphthalene, and wollastonite, while in the standard ceramic tiles, we'll be using mullite and crystalline. And as you can see from the microstructure under the SEM, you can see the difference between the microstructures themselves. The reason why the mechanical properties of the cake tiles is much more better is the presence of diopside itself, because diopside actually encourages the material to have a better mechanical property. So how are we actually contributing to the society? How are we actually helping our society? We're helping out with the resource efficiency for sustainability, because we're just using our trash again and again, right? So it's a closed material cycle. We'll be using our domestic and industrial waste. So we're going to enhance recycling, and we're going to encourage everybody to recycle their trash. Afterwards, we will actually contribute to the Earth's sustainability, because we're going to reduce the mining Since we're not going to be using pure clay as much as we did before, we're only going to be using our own trash, so we reduce the mining activities and we reduce the amount of land disposals. And then we're going to introduce an energy efficient processing, which will equal low temperature processing equals to save costs. Everybody likes money, right? Everybody wants to save money. So, as a conclusion, as you can see here in this cycle, for the current material cycle for the tiles itself, we'll be using dry milling, and we'll be sintered up to 1,200 degrees Celsius. While in our innovation side, we'll be using dry milling as well, but we'll only be using sintering up to 900 degrees Celsius. And that's all I have for today. Thank you so much for listening. And for those who are confused about duck turning into a rose duck, I'm sorry, I actually lied about that. The rose duck doesn't actually turn into a rose sorry, duckling doesn't actually turn into a rose duck. It turns into a beautiful swan. But let's all admit, the rose duck is just as beautiful as the swan. Thank you so much, and my name is